Yo, what is up? So it's time to continue our domination over the Europe in medieval total war. So in the first part we had some sort of troubles with these blue guys, which are French, but we managed. It came to a clutch at one point, and it was really annoying. It was a back and forth battle, and it still is, but we are looking good. The French are decimized and pushed. Now, the ideal situation would be to cut them off from here and have a safe line here so they cannot attack me from this side, and then push them as far as I can. And I'm gonna try to do that, and or form an alliance when I take this part. We shall see. But if the alliance fails and they don't accept the ceasefire, then we're gonna push them until they don't present any threat to us. We won't conquer them, and I won't do that. Not with the French, not with any enemies. I'm gonna leave every single fraction on one province. Why? Because if you conquer an enemy in medieval total war, 20 or 30 years later, or maybe in 5 years later from that moment when they disappear from the game, they will reappear with fully stacked armies on two, three provinces, and that's gonna be a pain to fight against. But if you leave them with one or two provinces, that's gonna eliminate that factor and help you a lot, because you don't have to fight huge hordes of armies. And then when you're ready, in one move, in one turn, you can conquer every single enemy at once and avoid that annoying factor of the game. So yeah, we are gonna focus on that. So our Florence are looking good. Let's see the expenses. Okay, 1600 per month. When it's all summed up, it's the pure profit. So we are here, and I'm planning to take Switzerland back. Let's just see. We can build troops, and these are the good ones. So we are gonna build feudal sergeants, and we can hire mercenaries here, which I will definitely do. And I'm gonna kill them instantly in this Frenchy battle up here, down here. Yeah. And then I'm gonna disband them because it puts a strain on my gold, as you see. Mercenaries are instantly on your side, but they cost gold. And whatever happens here, it's not a problem. Even if I lose, I'm gonna take out a lot of their units. And then I can come in with my regular armies and take them down. This part I'm leaving for now. I don't need to have that battle, because they are neutral and I can take them on any day. I'm conserving my troops in Florence for now, but I will strengthen my line of defense here, because French, they can attack any second. They are unpredictable, so I want power here. I want military numbers. I'm not gonna touch this part here. The rebellions have stopped, and I have enough troops to keep it. Norway, the troublesome Norway, it's okay. This province here, I'm gonna build troops here. Why not? They are close to French. I'm not gonna build here because I can move these troops if the rebellion happens. Sweden, okay. We are good. Now let's see how much Florence we will have after this turn. It will be a huge punch, a lot of troops. And we have the mercenaries on our side, so the income is a thousand florins less. Yeah, 3,000. Down the train. And we won that one. Nice. And it seems that no rebellions occurred this year, which I'm loving, absolutely loving. I'm thinking I'm gonna conquer Milan next, but I need these troops for that. The French are gonna lose this battle. I'm hoping they will. We shall see. If they win, that's the best case scenario. Then I can invade with my regular ones and take one more province. Yeah, but let's just keep moving and increasing our military power. Okay, Egyptians are getting closer. As I predicted, there is a rebellion here, and I will just do this, and we're good, we're fine. But the Egyptians are getting closer, which is not a problem for now because we have the Byzantines defending my back. It's gonna be a problem if they attack me because then I will have to defend against them. And we are already in a heated battle with the Frenchies. Now let's see our income. Yeah, it's still dwindling. Did I say it right? Well, it's still low because of the mercenaries, but I need them at this point. And now we don't necessarily have enough troops to do that, but we do have enough troops here. This is a diversion. This is a diversion so they don't attack this one. Now I'm gonna take it or get one turn. We shall see. And this part here, I can invade Milan, but then Burgundy, I don't even know, will be susceptible to attacks, so let's not do it yet. Let's get more troops. And yeah, okay, this is a certain loss. Not that big of a deal. And now, how will we defend it? Sending troops. Norway. And we have to strengthen this line here because this is the third or fourth time they are invading the Scandinavian countries, and I don't want that happening. Not when I'm planning to destroy them. Okay, now let's see. Let's see. What kind of troops we have here? They are not that strong, to be honest. But this could work. This could work. And I'm gonna risk it. I'm gonna risk it. Even if it's not smart, but I have the mercenaries here. Yeah, this will work. Let's just move these. So we avoid rebellions. And let's see. This is going to be a close one. No, it won't. Okay, what did they? They invaded Flanders. And so. Let's abandon the province. Yeah. So the debate was good. They sent out the troops there. And we got a free province there without losing a troop. Now that is a good commander. I am a good commander, and look at that. 10,000 florins. Easy. Easy. Heck yeah. French are getting their ass whooped. And I'm gonna use that money you just gave me, and I'm just gonna keep on coming. Let's see. Everything here is okay. We're getting troops. Now, let's see what. Oh, yeah. Now we can build crossbowmen. And these shielded ones, which are probably better. But I'm not a big fan of those. I'm just gonna keep building Vikings. They are still good. They still get the job done. Keep strengthening this line here, and hopefully I will end this. Let's see what awaits us. Oh, that's a long time. They are attacking. Yeah, that's a problem. But that was expected. They won't lie down and just let me take everything from them. It's time to defend, and this could be a problem. Oops. Because I don't have a lot of troops defending these areas. But we will work on it. Now, if I lose the next battle, I will have those troops ready. Now let's just create another diversion on the few fronts. And hopefully this will work. Now I can lose this battle because they have troops here. And they can conquer this one because 100 troops is not enough to defend against an invasion from here. But the rest should be good. Denmark, yeah. Attack and win. Good. Okay, that was bad. I should. Ooh. Win this. Okay, we have a free province. Should I fight this one? No, call out the attack. I should win one, this one, and I did. I should win this one, and I did. Okay, so we won some and we lost some. Now this one wasn't the most important one because they are now separated, but we did lost a province without a battle, which is quite annoying. To be honest, that was a big mistake to be made. That will slow us down a bit. But we can still keep on going, pushing French back. besiege them. What is our Florence status at the moment? We are good. I don't want to disband the mercenaries yet. Actually, I want to train some more if it's possible close to the fighting areas. Well, that will be it. Denmark invaded again. We have to defend it. Okay. And okay. And okay. And okay. And still no rebellions. I'm telling you. Auto-manage taxes works. Don't be greedy. Now, let's siege them. And let's strengthen our troops here. I wanna keep Flanders. I really do. And let's slow them down here. Even if we lose, it's not a problem. We do not lose a lot of troops. I wish I had boats. I wish I had boats, and I should start investing in them. But all of this fighting is costing me the boats. And these are the troops I wanted. To be honest, they are good. Really good. Even if they cost less than the feudal sergeants, they are good. Yeah, we're looking good so far. Now, I can keep pushing. Let's see what will happen after that. And then I'm gonna take this. I should be winning this fight. Yes. Good. And good. And good. We are on a streak right here, and the Germans are helping out. And now we have the French cornered. Now this is the perfect opportunity. Let's take out this one and then propose a ceasefire, because the Germans, and yeah, let's take this one down here. I noticed that Pope is not happy with my actions, so I have to be quick and take them out in the next year and stop attacking French. Because if I get excommunicated from the church, that will mean rebellions. My people don't like me when I'm not a good Christian. And we did it. With the Egyptians, they are conquering. I want to be friends with them because they are getting close to me. I'm gonna be friends with them, and maybe we can work together and build something nice. But for now, we are good. French are nowhere to be seen on the map. Now we can up our emissary game. Now I reckon I can build emissaries somewhere here, yeah, and somewhere else. I just have to find it, because I remember I... Oh, we can build ships. Good. Let's do that. Let's do that. Conquering pays off. So, troops, ships, emissaries. And this is the place I built the royal palace. Now I reckon I don't need to strengthen this part here while I do rebellions. But the French, I don't think they will attack me anytime soon with the ships over the seas. So yeah, let's keep building troops, creating troops. And then we shall see. I will probably focus more on these independent provinces. And after that, ships, definitely. It's important to be able to see what's happening on the map. And yeah, Germans can attack me at any point now. They want these places I have. It's their homeland. And French took it from them. And they have a big army here. But I reckon that's it. These two provinces, and that's it from the Germans. So yeah, troops are in check, boats are in check, defense is in check. Children are being made, like on a production line. And now, emissary. Where is our emissary? Ah, in the next turn, probably here. Yep, I'm gonna build three are gonna be enough, and then troops. Okay, and we are not at war with French anymore, but I'm not gonna be friends with Turkish. Because I don't want to. I don't like them. Now French. We have a rebellion here, which we are going to crush. And then, where is our emissary? Here he is. Now I want to check out Scotland and Ireland, because they are independent when you start the game. So who knows? Good. Now French did attack me, and they did start a war again. Now we have a new emissary here, and we are gonna use him to bribe these guys here. 3000 florins. And hopefully this time I can keep this province, because we did conquer it before and we failed to keep it because of the rebellions that were happening at the time there. But some battles you win and some battles you lose. And we just won a ship battle there. Did we? Yes, we did. Yeah, French want to cut me off, and they will keep fighting me. And did we lose the emissary there? No, we didn't. I just didn't make the move. And where is our other one? Ah, yeah, we did lose the emissary that was going to Scotland, so we have to try again. Yeah, that's gonna be it for this turn. This area is starting to annoy me, and I have to strengthen it up because rebellions, yeah, 74%. And I don't have the answer because I thought I had enough troops to keep it and to defend it effectively, but yeah, that didn't happen. Let's send a new emissary there, and since we lost one, our Danish spion got captured and killed, we have to make new ones. And again, oh, a general, that's not an emissary. Let's try to release this, see what's gonna happen. Because I'm executing the rebels, but they're coming and coming back. Now, our ship is doing good here. No more French ships. And now we can start doing something. I'm hoping that this one, this battle will end good. But I'm still gonna keep building ships and building them. Now, this emissary didn't get caught. And now I want to see what's happening here. Okay, that general was loyal and refused to join us. Oh well. Let's try it again. More money. Okay, let's see. Yeah, we have to refresh every single province with the troops. We're good with the Florence. I can go into the negative or into the minus at the moment because we have a lot. And we can lose Florence few turns. Now I'm just gonna go bonkers with the troops, and then we can start doing some serious conquering and possibly move onto the Spanish lands and fight the Turkish or Ottomans there. Troops for days, and you will be seeing me doing this often, just building too much troops. But you can never have too much troops or gold while Florence in this game. Ugh, we lost the ship. And again, a general was too loyal. Now, this is the second time I failed. Let's try it again. Nah, let's not. He's gonna offer the same amount of gold, and that won't happen, and he will just get killed. So I'm gonna abandon this mission. And where we are going to go next? Let's try here. And Scotland is by French. Ooh. Sorry about that. I have macros set up on my mouse and I accidentally clicked on one of them. Okay. Now we can't get to Ireland yet because we don't have the ships. Or there, and there isn't any boat yards here. Let's try it from here. And now it's a stalemate. This is the only province I can get at the moment. And I'm gonna wait a bit. Because there is a lot of troops there. Now the Byzantines are proposing an alliance with me. And I'm gonna reject it. And if they attack, I will kill them. Well, I will push them back from my lands. Let's see Moscow. How's the status there? And now I'm gonna invade Lithuania with everything that I have. And hopefully it will end good. Now French are again trying to take my ships out. And I'm gonna invade like this. Because I have extra troops there, and I have to take out these ports. Or not, I'm not gonna invade because I don't want the Pope to excommunicate me from the church. Sorry about that. Yeah, a solid win. Was expected. I don't want to be harsh. They expanded their areas. Let's shut down this rebellion. This one will fall to the Turkish, probably. Well, to the Egyptians. Yeah, these are the Egyptians, and I have to take out the French. I don't want to fight Italians or the Germans. These troops will manage, but I'm gonna do this. Yeah, I don't want those pesky rebellions happening. Now I reckon 2 more turns and 10 years will pass and I can invade France again. I made a good call allying up with Egyptians because they are taking out the purple ones in the Byzantine Empire, and I love that. But they are getting stronger by doing that, so it will be harder if they keep that much provinces for a long time. They will have a lot of gold. But I know something they don't. And I will explain it shortly. Okay, let's try. Let's go and take out Frenchies. Because because I can't build any ships at the moment. And we are losing gold. Now it's time to take some measures and release them. This is the first thing I need to do, because they are costing a lot of gold and I'm not using them, and they are not particularly useful. They are not the good type of troops that I would like to keep, and I have enough troops here. Now I'm gonna keep these, and now I can move these here and keep pushing the French away to the top. This will be enough to defend this area. Let's keep. Yeah, let's send these troops. They're gonna do good there. Okay, and I'm gonna keep these two armies here just to be safe from the Germans. Now this part, this is mine. No, it's not. It is. Yeah, I should put some troops there. And I'm gonna put troops. I'm gonna leave them here. They need to defend. Now let's see what's the status. Yeah, still losing, but after this battle, it will look way better. And I called it. The Germans are on the attack. And I'm gonna execute. Oh yeah. Let's see what's our alliance status. Ooh, that's a big hit. Now the Germans, I'm gonna keep them on one province. I'm gonna crush them right now. In the next turn, and I'm just gonna leave them with this province here. And so the French. Oh no, the English reappeared, and the French are left with only one province. I'm gonna take off to Wales, because it's neutral, and we shall see what will happen after that. And I have to deal with these rebellions here again, but since I don't have any boats, that's not possible. So boats, start investing right now. Okay, we can build them here. We can probably build a boatyard here and here and here. Now let's build a keep here and here, and that will allow us to build boats and here, because this is our main base of operation. And let's build a boatyard here. Nah, that's not smart. Here. I don't like the rebellions happening, and I don't want to invest money in something that can go away quite fast. Yeah, that was expected. I left the French to take that one. I didn't want to eradicate them. Those rebellions. Now let's see what's the situation. So the French are not at war with me, so we won! Yes. It took us about 150 years to beat the French. But we have a new juicy target here. A target that was stupid. Stupid enough to attack me. So Germans, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. But I will have to end you. And yeah, let's deal with these rebellions with more troops. 99% chance. Something is not good. And this one? 56. I will have to keep fighting them like this until I get the boats. Or I can just transfer more troops there. I have to do that. It will take me a long time to get the boats. It's time to move the troops. Okay, this will work. What's our Florence status? Ooh, that's not good. We are losing a lot. Where to now? Should we take out the Germans? I'm tempted to take them out. But since I don't have any boats, some of these troops are just wasted here. Now let's move this boat here. Can we? Yeah, shipyard is getting built. Ooh, I might have to release some troops or fight battles I don't want to fight at the moment. And because I'm gonna go into depth real soon, real soon. I'm thinking, what should I do? I can take on the Germans and I have enough troops to do that, and I don't need to wait for the boats to be ready. Let's do it. Let's wage wars. We don't have to, just for the sake of here. I don't want to fight them. Now Lithuania. Torn in my side. Look at these troops and these rebellions. Full troops. Let's assault the castle. Thank you. That will bite me in the ass soon. That will bite me in the ass because they will create a huge rebellion and they will just obliterate those parts. Oh well. That's fine by me at the moment because we are looking good. Let's keep moving these troops. And then we shall see. Who do we want to focus down next? Yeah, it's so hard to use these troops when you don't have any boats. This is not feasible. I need somebody to defend. We got somebody. Okay, this part here. And this part here. Yeah, we are losing a lot of gold, well, florins. That's why I'm forced to push. I created a bit too much troops. We're looking better, way better. But now, let's see who our friends are. The Egyptians and the Aragonese. So, and they are not a threat. Aragonese are not a threat at all. They all only have one province. So, Spanish, here I come. So yeah, I'm not focusing the Egyptians because they are gonna get wrecked by the Golden Horde, which appears in about 100 years from now. They're gonna appear here and they're gonna have like 30 fully stacked armies and they're gonna obliterate everything here with Attila on the lead. That is their commander, and that's an historical event. The Golden Horde Mongols, and they will appear and they will blitz everything and they will probably reach me and these areas will be attacked. I don't know about this part here, but they will reach me, so I'm not pushing that much to this point because I don't want to fight that battle. I'm gonna leave my enemies to do the dirty work and then I'm just gonna swoop in and clear the enemies. And they appeared. Oh, sooner than I expected. Well, my information was wrong. And now I'm not gonna be friends with Turkish. F you, Turk. I don't like Turks in this game. Spanish. Yeah, Spanish. You are not gonna like my invasion. Let's leave a bit of troops here. I'm gonna leave a little bit of defense here. I don't know, they might attack me. So the Mongols appeared. I clicked too fast, but I think those were the Mongols. Well, they are orange on the map, so we will notice them. They will start pushing immediately. So, nobody has broken the alliance with me, so I can keep pushing against the Spanish. Now the boats. We have some boats here and here, and the boats will be ready, so I can move them like this. And I can hopefully get to Ireland and conquer Ireland if it's free. Okay, I can win this. Yeah. No, I missed clicked again. No. Well, I will just cut the list then. I'm gonna stay friends with the Egyptians. And let's not misclick this time. And let's take this Spanish province and assault this castle here. What's the status? Still losing a lot. And this province is so annoying. The amount of troops I am using to defend it, it's just not worth it. It's bringing like 400 florins, and this one is bringing 330, and I don't know, it's just not worth it. Yeah. Oh, and I didn't check Ireland. But yeah, it's free. Free for taking. We can win this one. And we did. And we won this one too. And we won this one too. Let's see the status. We are still good. Now, I'm gonna send these troops. Should I? I mean, I can have the Spanish whipped. I probably have them whipped right now. So yeah, let's not rush it. We don't need to take them out. And I'm gonna take Ireland with the emissary I don't have, but I can jump to it, which is good. Now let's choose a good position. But I don't have a lot of troops. Yep, I can't jump from there, and I don't want to use these troops. Okay, yeah, I know what to do. Boats. I forgot all about boats. Build a keep there and here. That should hopefully lower the the amount of rebellions happening. Let's build a keep here. We don't have money to do that. Jeez. Yeah. We might have to fight another war that we don't want to. Yeah, playing passive with a lot of troops is a bit challenging. Yeah, I'm losing a lot of gold. Hopefully, these provinces will help out. Now we have a rebellion up here, which we are going to stop. And here too, possibly going to happen. Now I don't have a lot of troops in the middle that can defend everything, but I can use these. Now I would make an emissary and take Ireland from here. But since I don't have any gold, that's not going to happen. I'm gonna move the ships here. And then I can jump and use these armies. Since the Golden Horde is not attacking me yet. And I have to kill off some troops. It's still not enough. Byzantines are always thinking too much. Okay, my king has just died. Now, Hungarian King Béla wants to be friends. Sure, let's be friends. Okay. So, I don't want to be friends anymore with the Russians. I'm gonna kill them. Because they are really passive and not that. Well, every time I play the game, they were really passive. And this works in my favor because I have tons of troops here that can work. So it's time. Yeah, we are waging wars left and right. And I'm enjoying it way too much. Way too much. Ugh. Okay. So we have a boat here. Let's see how connected we are. That was a boat that was made in the last turn. This one. Okay, let's see if I can leap from here. Nope. Why? Because of the French boats? Maybe. Nope, no, the port is here, so I technically, yeah, I can leap from here. Nana! We are definitely going to do that. Because we have extra troops. Now I should. Now I'm gonna wait a few turns until I get more boats. Then we are going to move the boats. No, I'm not gonna invest in buildings at the moment because I don't have anything to invest. just gonna stick to the essentials, and those are the boats at this point. Build boats, build ships, get more mobility, and destroy everything. And then we're gonna invest in more florins, in more income. But yeah, you need ports on every possible province that is connected to the sea, so you can leave, like I will do in the next turn. You can see how huge my reach has just gotten. That was expected. Now, let's do this like this. Okay, we are getting closer to zeroing out our losses per month, and this will do. Okay, now the problem is this area here. I need to make some troops here that can defend effectively, and that then we shall stop with the expansion, because my monthly income, well, not monthly, yearly income is low. I need to work on the structures, and for the next 20-30 years I will be passive. Just took out the Russians. %85%. That's a lot of percentage to have on the rebellion. Yeah, this is better. Now this is 36. Let's move some. There, now it's 6, and this part here 74. Oosh. %69. God damn it. I'm gonna scratch this one. I don't need it. Yeah, 49 income, that's nothing. They can have it. The rebels can have it. They can live in poverty. See if I care about it. I need to strengthen my troop count here. And what's the income? Still in the minus. Look at these expenses here. Oh my God, that's too much. And these. Like, I'm defending places that bring nothing compared to the amount of gold I'm spending on the troops that are defending those places. Have to figure out what to do since I'm not getting enough boats. And the Egyptians are cornering me. Fight anybody else right now, and I think that will be the case. Yeah, Golden Horde is here, and that will help me out. Perfect. That will help me out. That's the idea. They will weaken everybody around me, and then I will swoop in. Now, what's the dealio? Yeah, we are still losing gold, and we are getting some invasions. Well, not invasions, rebellions. Let's split these units up and strengthen our position there. Now, this is the place we had a rebellion, and we are gonna send some troops that way. And this is it for this turn. Yeah, slow. But I have to wait out to see the outcome of the Golden Horde. I don't want to disband troops to earn Florence, because if the Golden Horde succeeds and gets to me, then that will be a problem. I'm gonna keep my friendship with the Egyptians, but the problem is we are getting rebellions, and it's not necessarily a problem because we are gonna get into the fights, and that means we're gonna lose some troops, and that means, oh no. How much gold? 300 florins. You know what? I'm gonna abandon Novgorod. Should I abandon it? Let's see how much troops does it require. 67. Oh my God, that's a lot of troops. These rebellions in check, and the problem is I cannot build more troops. Okay, let's sort it by income and see Which provinces are, yeah, Norway, Switzerland, Ireland. I don't want to lose those provinces, especially Norway. It took me some time to get it. But yeah, these rebellions will help out and weaken me enough so I can earn cash and invest. Yeah, that's expected. They will keep coming. Now, something happened here, yeah. A huge Spanish rebellion, and I'm gonna leave this province right now. The idea is these two are gonna get into battle, and then I can go for them. Do I have any princesses? Okay, I have one in Milan. Gonna use her to stop fighting with the Spanish. Not because I'm scared, I just don't wanna deal with that at the moment. I do have to focus on the Florence. Now troops. Yeah, I have to cancel everything out and focus on increasing my income. That's the main deal at the moment. Now I'm gonna send this ship here and this one here and then here. Okay, we're starting to get some control. Now, I could fight Egyptians, but these areas, they don't bring a lot of money. Crimea does, and these parts here, but that about sums it up. There is no need to go and fight those battles, not yet. Ouch. And the Germans are here to fight me. Eesh. I told you so. I told you that will happen. Okay, time to move these boats here and here. And now I can jump. Well, in the next turn. And in this one, with this. Can I sum up enough troops? Stop them right now. This will cause even more rebellions, but I don't care at this point, I really don't. Need to stop them at this moment. This is the best we can get at the moment. And this is good, a rebellion. Let's use these troops. I really don't understand it. Yeah, the keep. We need the garrison side a size, and then the rebellions will stop. Invaded. No. I have to play it safe. Ouch. Ouch. Okay, probably the Turks. And the Spanish don't want to be friends. Fine by me. Okay, let's see. I should probably just leave the Germans right now. What's the situation? Okay, we are finally earning some gold. Now, I can go and take them out. But I'm not going to. I'm gonna just stay put. I'm gonna stay put, defend my positioning, build structures, and just avoid rebellions. Rebellions are holding me back at the moment, so that's the main goal. Get the garrison size up, build keeps and castles, and just get money, and then push again. So yeah, this is the end of part 2. Hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I didn't stutter way too much. But it's hard to talk for 2 hours constantly. Yeah, so yeah, goodbye.